B'siyata d'shmaya maseches Megillah daf tezayin. We're starting on the third line from the top of the Omud. The Gemara is in the middle of going through the Psukim in Megillas Esther. We're up to Perek Vav Pasuk Gimel. The Pasuk says, Vayomer HaMelech Ma'anasa Yokoru Gdula Namordechai Alze. Vayomeru Nari HaMelech Mesharosov Loi Nase Imoy Dovor. The Mesharosim didn't say that Loi Nase Yokoru Gdula, which would be an accurate response to Achashverosh's question, Ma'anase Yokoru Gdula. They said, Loi Nase Imoy Dovor, as if to stress that not only Yokoru Gdula wasn't given to him, but nothing was given to him. Omar Rava explains, Loi Mipnei She'oyavim Es Mordechai. It's not as if these Mesharosim were great friends of Mordechai, Elim Mipnei She'soinim Es Haman, they hated Haman, and therefore they were okay that Haman's enemy Mordechai should receive a reward. Now the Gemara is going now to Perek Vav Pasuk Dalet of the Megillah. The Pasuk says, V'homon bo, V'goymer, Leimer la'melech litlois es Mordechai aloeitz asher heichin loy. The question is, why does it have to say Asher Heichin loy? It would be enough to say Asher Heichin. He prepared the gallows. Loy, for him? Tana. So the Braisa says, Loy Heichin. It's as if the Pasuk is prophesizing or saying that he created the gallows for himself. Now Megillas Esther Perek Vav Pasuk Yud, it says Va'asei Chein LeMordechai HaYehudi HaYoshiv B'Shar HaMelech. The Gemara is now going to discuss why do we need such a lengthy description of Mordechai. Mordechai, Yehudi, Yoshiv B'Shar HaMelech. Says the Gemara, Omar Le, Haman pretended he didn't know who Achashverosh was talking about, and Haman said to Achashverosh, Manu Mordechai, who's Mordechai? Omar Le, Achashverosh said, HaYehudi, the Yid. Omar Le, Haman said to Achashverosh, two Mordechai could be Yehudi. There's lots of Mordechais in Klal Yisrael. How am I supposed to know who you mean? Omar Le, Achashverosh said to him, HaYeshiv B'Shar HaMelech, I mean the Mordechai HaYehudi who sits by the gates of the palace. And now that Haman understood exactly what was expected of him, and that Achashverosh wanted him to go and give all this cover to Mordechai, Omar Le, Haman said to Achashverosh, Sagi Le Bechad Diskrakto, it'll be enough if he gets a reward, a village in some place, Inami Bechad Nara, or give him a river somewhere where he can gain from the taxes that people travelling through will pay. But to give him the big de Malchus, and that he should ride on the horse of the Melech, why do we have to go that far? Omar Le, Achashverosh said to him, Ho Nami Havli, besides for everything that you said, thinking it was going to go to you, Haman, that he was going to wear the royal clothes and ride on the royal horse, also give him a kfar or a river. That's what the Pasuk says, Al tapil dovo mikoila shedibarato. Everything that you've mentioned, give it all to him. Now the Gemara is moving to the next Pasuk, Perek Vav, Pasuk Yud Aleph, Vayikach homon es halavush ve'es hasus. Gemara is now going to explain exactly what transpired. Ozal Haman went, Ashkechei, he found Mordechai, the Yosfi Rabbonon Kamei, the Talmidim was sitting in front of him, Umachveluhu Hilchis Kmitza, Le Rabbonon. He was showing the Chachomim with his hands how exactly one takes a koimetz in the Beis Hamikdash. Kiven de Chazye, Mordechai de Apik, Le Kiblei, the Susei, Mechad Biyadei. Since Mordechai saw that Haman was coming towards him with a horse in his hand, he was leading a horse, Mirtas, he was afraid. Omar lehu l'rabbonon, Mordechai said to the Talmidim, Hai Roshia l'mikdal nafshi ka'osi, this Rosh Haman is coming to kill me. Zilu mikamei, hide from him. Diloi tikovu begachalosui, that you should not get hurt from him. Bahu shaita, at that point, nis'atif Mordechai. Mordechai donned his talis. V'komle litzleisa, he was davening to Hashem. Also Haman. Haman came with Yosef leikamayu, and he sat down in front of Mordechai and the Talmidim. V'oirich ad desolik Mordechai litzleisa. He waited until Mordechai finished davening. Omar lehu. Haman asked the Talmidim, B'mayoskitu, what inyan were you just busy learning about? Omrulei, the Talmidim said to Haman, that we were learning the halachas of kmitza. Bizman shebeis hamikdash kayim, in the time when there was a beis hamikdash, manda menadev mincha, if somebody had to bring a korban mincha, ma'isem meloy kum tzedot sulto, he would take a fistful of flour, put it on the mizbeach, umiskaperle, and with that, it would be mechaper on his averus. Omar lehu, so Haman said, also meloy kum tza kimcha, didchu, a fistful of flour of yours that you bring on the mizbeach was strong enough. Vidochi asoro alfei kikrei kasper didi. It overpowered the 10,000 kikar of silver that I was prepared to give Achashverosh in order to destroy Klal Yisrael. Omar Le, Mordechai said to Haman, Rosha, how can you say it was your money that you were prepared to give Achashverosh? Eved shekonu nechosim, when a servant, a slave, buys nechosim, Eved lemi u nechosim lemi. The Eved belongs to the master and everything he buys belongs to the master. All the money that you were prepared to give to Achashverosh, it's my money. Now the Gemara continues to explain to us what transpired after that. Omar Le, Haman said to Mordechai, Kum levoish hanemone, stand up and wear these clothes, the royal clothes, urachoyiv haisusya, and ride on this royal horse. The boyeloch malka, Melech Achashverosh wants to give you a lot of covet. Omar Le, Mordechai said to him, Lo yechilna, I can't wear these royal clothes and ride on the royal horse. Ad da'oyelna lebe bonei ve'eshkei lemazya. Until I go into the bathhouse and I wash myself and I have a haircut. De'lav oirech ara nishtamushi b'monei de'malka hochi. It's not appropriate or proper that one should wear these clothes in a disheveled state like this. Now Esther heard about this request of Mordechai. Shodra Esther va'asartinhu lekulhu beiboni ulekulhu umoni. She decreed that all those responsible of the bathhouses and all those responsible to give haircuts should close shop. Aile ihu lebeiboni. Haman had no choice and he himself had to take Mordechai into the bathhouse. Va'aschei, he had to wash him. Va'ozel va'aisa zuzami beisei, he had to go home and bring a pair of scissors, the koshokil beimazye, and he had to cut his hair. But how did the koshokile, whilst Haman was giving Mordechai a haircut, ingad, he was about to pass out, v'isnach, and he was moaning. Omar Le, Mordechai said to Haman, am I komisnachas? Why are you krechting? What's the problem? Omar Le, Haman said to Mordechai, gavra dehach v'choshiv le lemalko mikulhu ravravonohi, a person who was a minister that was more choshiv than all the other ministers in the kingdom, referring to himself. Hashta lishavye baloni v'sapor, I've now become a bath attendant and a barber. Omar Le, Mordechai said to Haman, Rosha, you Rosha, v'lav sapor shel kvar kartzum ha'yisa. Look back in your history. You used to be a barber in the village of Kartzum, so you've just gone back to what you always were. That's not a reason to moan. Tana, indeed we find a braisa that says that Haman sapor shel kvar kartzum ha'yo esrim v'shtayim shana. Haman had been a barber for 22 years. Continues the Gemara. Bosa de shaklin hu lemazye. After Haman finished giving Mordechai a haircut, Livshinhu lemoni, he clothed him with royal clothes. Omar Le, Haman said, Sak urachav, now go up onto the horse on which you'll ride. Omar Le, Mordechai said to him, Lo yechilna, I can't go up. Dekhisho cheiloi nimei tanisa, because I was fasting, I'm very weak. Gochin, Haman had no choice, he had to bend over with Solik. And Mordechai used Haman as a ladder, as a pedestal. He stood on Haman in order to get up onto the horse. Ki Solik, while Mordechai was going up, bought bay, he gave him a kick. Omar Le, Haman said to Mordechai, Lo iksiv lechu, does it not say in your Torah, B'nefoy lo yivcha al tismach, that when your enemies have a downfall, you shouldn't be happy? Omar Le, Mordechai said to him, Hanemili b'Yisrael. Yes, our enemies who are Yidden, when they have a downfall, we don't express joy. Aber b'titchu, from the Goyim, k'siv v'ato al bo moisei moisidrich. You can be happy at their downfall. Now in Pasuk Yud Aleph it says, v'yikra lefonov, that whilst Haman was taking Mordechai around the town, he was crying in front of him, kocho ye'ose lo ish asher hamelech chofetz bikori. The Gemara explains, ki have a nokit v'ozil b'shvile de be'Haman, when Haman was passing by his own house, Chazye Brate de Kaima Igra. His daughter saw him from high up on the roof. Sovra, she mistakenly thought, Hai de Rochiv, the one on top of the horse, Avua, is her father Haman. The Hai de Mazge Kameh, and the one that's walking in front of the horse, Mordechai, must be Mordechai. Shokla Atzitza, the base Hakisei, she took the tub that was used as the bathroom, thinking she was going to pour it on Mordechai's head, she ended up pouring the whole thing on Haman's head. Dole eine, Haman lifted his eyes to see who threw this down on him, and then his daughter saw that she had thrown it onto her father. And from shock and pain, noflo meigro la'ara, she threw herself down, or she fell down from the roof, right down, umeisa, and she died. The Gemara says, "V'hainu dechsiv." That's what it says in Pasuk Yud Beis. "V'yoshav Mordechai el Shar Hamelech." That he came back to the Shar Hamelech. The question is, he didn't come back to the Shaar HaMelech. He was not at the Shaar HaMelech to start with. He was in the Beis HaMedrash teaching Torah. What does it mean he went back? Omer of Sheshes. Of Sheshes explains, Sheshov l'sakai ulatanisoi. He went back to the state of fasting and wearing sackcloth. And he sat with his sackcloth at the gates of the palace. And the Hemshech HaPosuk that says, V'homon nitchaf el beisei ovil v'chafui roish. Homon went back into his house in a not such pleasant state, but he was also called an ovil. He was mourning. Says the Gemara, ovil al bitoi. He was mourning on his daughter that had just died. V'chafui roish al shira lei. He had been completely humiliated by what had just happened to him, that his daughter had just poured a whole basin full of not such pleasant content onto his head. Now the Gemara moves to prosecute Gimel. Vayisaper Haman lezeresh ishtoi ulechol oyhavov is kol asher korohu vayomru lo chachomov vezeresh ishtoi. The Gemara's medayik koruluhu oyhavov koruluhu chachomov. It says that he was vayisaper Haman lechol oyhavov vayomru lo chachomov. So it seems that initially they were not called chachomim. It seems that they were only called chachomim consequent to something that they told Haman. Omer Rabbi Yechon explains, Kol ha'imer dvar chochma, afilu b'umo yisa'ilam, anyone who says any dvar chochma from chochmas ha'teira, even if they're a goy, nikra chochem, it's called a chochem. And what dvar chochma did these oyhavov tell Haman that made them deserving of the title chachomov? They said, im mizera yehudim mordechai v'goymer, leisucha loiki nofil tipoi lefonov. Omru lei, they told Haman, im mishar shvotim ka'osei, if Mordechai is a descendant of any of the other Shvatim, Yachlisle, it could be that you'll defeat him. V'im ishevet Yehuda o Binyamin v'Ephraim o Menashe? But if he comes from one of these Shvatim, Yehuda o Binyamin, Ephraim o Menashe, lo Yachlisle, you don't stand a chance. Since these Shvatim, they were given a bracha that they would defeat their enemies. Yehuda, tichsiv yodcha bo'iref oyvecha. Yaakov told Yehuda that he's always going to defeat his enemies. V'inoch and the other three shvatim, Binyamin, Ephraim, Menashe, tichsiv behu lifnei Ephraim, u'Binyamin, u'Menashe, oyroro es gvurosecho. That Hashem is going to be on their side, and there's no way it's possible to defeat them. The Gemara now brings part of the pasuk Yud Gimel, ki nofoil tipoil lefonov. Dorash Rabbi Yehuda bar Iloi, shtei nefilois halolu loma. Why does it say a double loshen, nofoil tipoil? It seems that he fell twice. Omruloi, the Chachomim said to Homon, umazu, referring to Klal Yisrael, mashula la'ofor, they're compared to earth. It's a pasuk that says, v'samti ezarach o ka'afara oretz. Umashula la'kichovim, they're compared to stars, as the pasuk says, "Usfeir hakeichovim, etc." Koi yezaracho. Kesheim yerdim. When they fall, yerdim adofer. They get trampled on by the umos oilim. Ukesheim oilim. But when they rise, oilin ad lekeichovim. They rise all the way up to the stars. It's impossible to be on top of them. And that's why it says, "Nofel tipoil." That you're going to start falling, and they're going to start going up. And ultimately, that will be a double fall for you, Haman. And Pasuk Yudalid it says, V'sarise ha-melech higiu, v'yavhilu lehovi es Haman. So the Pasuk Pshat in v'yavhilu means they rushed him. Now the Lashon of the Pasuk, l'katchila, the instruction that Achashverosh gave was, maharu es Haman, bring Haman quickly, a Lashon of mahir. And here the Pasuk changes it to v'yavhilu. It's obviously coming to teach us something. Says the Gemara Melamed, it's teaching us, shehevi'uhu b'bohola. When they took him, he was in a state of fear and panic. He didn't even manage to wash himself down from the shower he'd received from his daughter. Now in Perek Zayin, Pasuk Dalet of Megillas Esther, it says, Ki nimkarnu ani ve'ami ve'goymer, ki ein hatzor shoyve benezek hamelech. The Gemara darshens as follows. Omro loy Esther seta chashverish tzor ze. This enemy, referring to Haman, eino shoyve benezek shel melech. He doesn't care about causing a loss to the melech. In the past, ikani baba Vashti uktala. He was jealous of Vashti, and he advised you to kill your wife, Vashti. It didn't bother him that you lost your wife. Hashta ikani bedidi. Now he's jealous of me that I'm the queen now. Umiboy lemiktili, wants to kill me. Then in Perek Zayin Pasuk Hey, it says Vayomer Amelech Achashverish. Vayomer LeEsther Amalka. Asks the Gemara Vayomer Vayomer Lomoli. Why does the pasuk say twice Vayomer? It would be enough to say that Vayomer Amelech Achashverish LeEsther Amalka. Why does it say twice Vayomer? Omer Bavor. Bavor explains that indeed Esther heard what Achashverish said twice. Betchila, before she revealed that she was a Bas Yisrael, Achashverosh was used to speaking to her al yidei Turguman. It was below Achashverosh's dignity to speak to her directly. And there was a Meturguman, somebody, a translator in between them. He would pass the messages to her through a middle person. Kiven de omrole midabes shaul karsine. After it became clear to Achashverosh that she was a Bas Yisrael, a descendant of Shaul HaMelech, miyad vayomer le'Esther HaMalka. He spoke to her directly, not via Meturguman. In Pasuk Vav it says, Vatemer Esther, Ish tzar v'oyev haman ra'azeh. Now Achashverosh asked her, Mihu zev ezehu. She should have just answered, Haman ra'azeh. What was this introduction, Ish tzar v'oyev? Omer Rabbi Elazar melamed, Shehoisa mechavo klape Achashverosh. She intended to point at Achashverosh and say, I mean you. That's the Ish tzar v'oyev. Ubo malach v'sotar yodo. Malach came and pushed her hand aside, klape Haman, to point at Haman, and then she said, Haman haraze. Now the next psukim in the Megillah, v'hamelech kom b'chamosoi el ginas habison v'goymer, v'hamelech shov miginas habison. Why did they have to say twice that it was miginas habison? It says that v'hamelech kom b'chamosoi el ginas habison. It should say afterwards, v'hamelech shov. Why did it say again, miginas habison? Explains the Gemara, makish shiva, the return of Achashverosh from the Ginas Habison is compared l'kima to his leaving when going out to the Ginas Habison. Ma'kima, when he got up to leave Bechema, he was in a rage. Afshiva, when he came back, Bechema, he had added reason to be in a rage. What happened when he was in the Ginas Habison that caused him even more rage? Explains the Gemara, the Azal, he went to the Gina, va'ashkach, and he found the Malachi Asharas, that were Malachim de Idmulei Kegavri, that looked like people, v'ka'okri li'iloni de Bustoi. They were uprooting the trees of the gardens. Va'omar Ruach Asher said to them, Ma'ev odeteichu, what are you doing? Omrulei, the Malachim said, De Pagdin on Haman. Haman told us to uproot the trees. And in a rage, also Lebesei, that's how he came back into his house. When Achashverosh came back into the palace, it says in Pasuk Ches, V'Haman noifel al amito asher Esther oleo. Asks the Gemara, noifel? Why is the Gemara using the term noifel, that he was constantly in a state of falling? Nofal, it should say he fell, mi boilei. He fell onto the bed. He only fell once. Omer Rabbi Elazar says, Rabbi Elazar melamed shebo malach vehipiloi oleo. Indeed, he fell once, and when Haman tried to stand up, the malach came and pushed him down again. Every time he tried to stand up, he got pushed down again. When Achashverosh saw first what was going on in the Ginas Habison, that they were chopping down his trees, and then he came back into the room and he saw Haman falling on Esther's bed, Omar, he said, Vai mi beisa, vai mi boro. Woe to me in my house and woe to me outside the house. And that's what it says, Vayomer HaMelech Hagam Lichboish Es HaMalko Imi Babois. Hagam means not only that your messengers are destroying my gardens, but you're causing me tzoros in my home as well. And the Pasuk says in Pasuk Tes, Vayomer Charvoino V'goymer Gam Hine Yo'itz Asher Oso Haman L'Mordechai V'goymer Gavoya Chamishim Amo. Omer Belozo, Af Charvoino Rosha. Be'etem Charvoino is also a Rosha. Bo'iso Eitza Hoyo. He was the one that advised Haman to hang Mordechai and to make the gallows. That's how he knew that the gallows was 50 amos high. Kivon shero shelo niskaimu atzosi. Since he saw that Haman's plans had failed, miyad borach, he changed sides and he stopped helping Haman. V'haynu dechsev, and that's what it says in the psukim regarding Roshoim. Vayashleich olav v'lo yachmel miyodei boreach yivroch. Hashem punishes the Roshoim without any rachmonus, and those who were there to help the Roshoim l'katchila run away from him. And that's what happened here. First, Charvoina was in it with Haman, and then he turned against Haman by telling Achashverosh that Haman made the gallows for Mordechai. Now it says in Pasuk Yud, Vayislu es Haman aloeitz ashehichin l'Mordechai, v'chamas hamelech shchocho. Now the Gemara's medayik that shchocho means that he calmed down is normally written with one chof. Vayoshechu hamayim, Kesheich Hamas HaMelech, and here it says Shchocho with two chofs. Says the Gemara, Shtei Shchichois Halolu Loma. There was a double act of calming down. Achas Shel Malkui Shel Olam. The Rabbeinu Shleilim at that point was Moichel Klal Yisrael on the fact that they bowed down to the idol. The Mefarshim suggest that since Haman himself made himself into an Avodah Zarah, now that Haman is hung, then the Avira of Avodah Zarah that Klal Yisrael had done was Niskapir. V'achas shel Achashverosh. Achashverosh himself also calmed down. He was now happy to hear that the decree against Klal Yisrael should be annulled. V'omrile, some say, that the two shchichos were both attributed to Achashverosh. Achashverosh had two things to calm down from. Achas shel Esther. Achashverosh was furious that Haman tried to kill Esther, and now he could calm down. V'achas shel Vashti. He was furious at Haman for encouraging him to kill Vashti, and now he managed to calm down from that as well. Now the Gemara is going to continue to the next sugya, explaining to us what happened when Yosef revealed himself to his brothers in Mitzrayim, and that's going to bring us back to the parasha of Mordechai. The Pasuk says that after Yosef found the brothers, he asked them to go and bring Yaakov to Mitzrayim. And then it says, Lechulam, meaning to all his brothers, Nosan Leish Chalifois Smolois. He gave them clothes. Ule Binyamin, but to his brother Binyamin, Nosan Chomish Chalifois, he gave five clothes. The Gemara asks, Efsha Davoshen its dire boy Oisoi Tzadik, Yikoshel boy. The whole reason that his brothers sold him, Yosef, to Mitzrayim was because of the Ksonis Pasim, the coat that Yaakov gave Yosef, and he didn't give to the other brothers. And now Yosef himself is favoring Binyamin over the other brothers, as if to say he's making the same mistake again as Yaakov did. Obviously, we mustn't talk about mistakes here. These are Kedoshe Elyon. But the Gemara wants to understand what was behind it. Now the Gemara says, and how do I know that Yosef was sold to Mitzrayim by his brothers because Yaakov favored him? The Omar Rav Bar Machasya, Omar Rav Chomer Bar Guri Omar Rav, Bishvil Mishkal Shnei Sloim Melas, because of the weight of two sloim of clean and valuable wool, Shehosif Yaakov LeYosef, that Yaakov added on this cloak that he gave Yosef, Mishar Echov, more than he gave the other brothers, they were jealous of him, Misgalgel Adover. One thing led to the next, V'yarudu Aviseinu LeMitzrayim, and Klal Yisrael turned out as slaves in Mitzrayim. Answers the Gemara Omer Binyamin Bar Yefes, that the reason Yosef added to Binyamin the five clothes was remez romaz loy. He felt it necessary to give Binyamin this remez, she'osid ben lotzeis mimenu, that Binyamin would have a descendant, she'yetze melifnei amelech b'chamisha levushe malchus. He would also be the Mishnah Lemelech, just like Yosef was, and he would go out with five royal clothes. She'nemer, as it says in the Pasuk, here in Megillas Esther, Perek Ches, Pasuk Tezvov, u'mordecha yotzo melifnei amelech, בלבוש מלכוס תחילס וחור ותרס זוב גדוי לו וסחרך פוץ וארגומון. Now the Gemara brings more psukim to do with the way Yosef and the brothers met up and what transpired after that. So the pasuk says, "Vayipoil al tzavrei Binyamin ochiv, vayevk uBinyamin bocha al tzavorov." Yosef fell on the necks of Binyamin and cried, and Binyamin cried on Yosef's necks. Asks the Gemara, "Kamo tzavorin havulei leBinyamin? How many necks did Binyamin have?" It says a loshen rabin, tzavrei Binyamin. Answers the Gemara, "Rabbi Lazar, that the tzavor is referring to the Beis Hamikdash. There's a pasuk in Shashirim that says, 'Kemigdal David tzavorich, bocho al shnei mikdashim.' Yosef cried on the churban of both Bate Mikdash. Shasidim liyos bechelkei shel Binyamin, that were going to be largely in Binyamin's chelek, vasidim nechoriv, and they're going to get destroyed. UBinyamin bocho al tzavorov." And Binyamin that cried on Yosef's neck, Bocho al Mishkan Shiloi, she'osid li es bechelkei shel Yosef, ve'osid li choriv. In Yosef's chelek, in Shiloi, there was going to be a Mishkan that was also going to get destroyed. Binyamin saw this benevuah and cried on that. Continues the Gemara, that Yosef said to the brothers, V'hinei eineichem ro'os, ve'einei ochi Binyamin, Now Yosef said, "Einechem rois, your eyes can see." Why did he have to single out Binyamin by saying, "Ve'einei ochi Binyamin"? Omer Belozer explains that Yosef was trying to teach the brothers a profound lesson. Omer Lemi said to them, "Kashem she'ein belibi al Binyamin ochi." In the same way as I have no anger whatsoever against my brother Binyamin, she'lo yhoyo b'mechirosi, he was not present when I got sold. Kach ein belibi aleichem, so too I am not bearing any grudge against you, even though you sold me to Mitzrayim. And if you suspect that I'm just saying it, and I'm not actually feeling that way in my heart, ki fi Hamadabir Aleichem, and the words kipi can be darshened kafi, not because my mouth, but as my mouth, the same way as the words I'm saying from my mouth, kain libi. So too I feel in my heart, I am not bearing a grudge against any of you. Later on it says in the Psukim, Ula'oviv sholach kozois asoro chamoirim noisim mituv mitzrayim. The Gemara explains, my mituv mitzrayim says that the donkeys were carrying from the tuv of Mitzrayim. What was that? Omer ben Yomin bar Yefes, Omer ben Lozo, sholach lo yayin yoshon. Yosef sent Yaakov aged wine, shedas zekeinim noichoy menu. Aged people appreciate and benefit from such wine. Now after the brothers came back from burying Yaakov Avinu, the Pasuk says, vayelchu gam echov vayiplu lefonov. Omer ben Yomin bar Yefes, Omer ben Lozo. The Belozo is now going to explain why the brothers bowed to Yosef, even though they were older than him, and they were more choshev to him. Ha'inu da'omrinchi, that's what people say, ta'alo, be'idne, a fox, at a time when it is ruling, even the lion admits, segidle, that you have to bow down to the fox. So even though the other brothers may have been more choshev than Yosef, but at this point Yosef was the king, and they acted that way towards him. Asks the Gemara, Ta'alo, you're comparing Yosef to a fox, and the other brothers are compared to lions? Mai betzirusei me'achoya, with what was he less than his other brothers? Answers the Gemara, Elo'i etmar hochi etmar. This phrase of Rebbe Loza was not said in context of Yosef versus the other brothers. It was said in a different context. The Pasuk says that before Yaakov Avinu passed away, Vayishtachu Yisrael al Rosh HaMito, that Yaakov, who was an aged father, when Yosef came in, he bowed towards Yosef. Omer ben Yomin bar Yefes, Omer ben Ozor, that the reason that Yaakov bowed to Yosef was Talo b'idnei Sgidle. And clearly Yosef, relative to his father, was like a shu'al, a fox, relative to a lion. Then the Pasuk carries on, Vayinochim oisam vaydabir alibam. Yosef consoled the brothers and spoke to their heart. Omer ben Yomin bar Yefes, Omer ben Ozor, Melamed she'omar lohem dvorim shemiskablim al aliv. Yosef said to them things which the heart managed to receive. What did he say to them? Umor asoro neiros, lo yochlu lechabois neir echod. In the same way as if you have 10 candles with smoke rising from all 10. The smoke would not extinguish a single candle which is positioned on top of those 10. Even more so, neir echod, a single candle with the smoke that's rising from it, heich yochi lechabois asoro neiros, it will certainly not extinguish 10 candles positioned above it. The message he was trying to give them was saying that in the same way as 10 brothers didn't manage to harm one brother, Yosef, even more so, Yosef would not be able to harm his 10 brothers. Now the Gemara is going back to Megillas Esther, Perek Ches Pasuk Tezayin. After Haman was hung and the Gezerah was Nizbatil, the Pasuk says, La'ihudim hoi so'ira v'simcha v'sosein v'yikar. Omer v'yuda, V'yuda explains, O'ira, when the Pasuk says O'ira zu Teira, it means Teira. And Rashi explains that Haman was Geizer, they were not allowed to learn Teira. And after Haman was defeated, they could continue learning Torah without fear. V'cheinu oimer, we find in the Psukim in Mishli, ki neir mitzvah Torah oir. Torah is compared to an oir. Simcha, when it says, Lehudim hoisa oir of a simcha, what was the simcha referring to? Zu Yom Tov. Consequent to the Gzeris of Haman, Klal Yisrael had a challenge to keep Yom Tov, and after Haman was defeated, they could keep Yom Tov. Some explain this is referring to what we saw before, that Haman told Achashverosh that Klal Yisrael don't work or pay taxes because they say Pesach Hayoim, Shabbos Hayoim, as if every day is a Yom Tov. So Haman was mekatrig on the Yomim Tovim, and possibly Achashverosh responded to Haman's claim and may have banned Klal Yisrael from keeping Yom Tov. And now that Haman was gone, they could keep Yom Tov. V'cheinu oimer v'samachto v'chagecho. You see that Simcha is associated to Yom Tov. Sosoin, when it says that Klal Yisrael had Sosoin Zumila, Haman was geizer that they were not allowed to do Bris Mila, and after he was hung, they could do Bris Mila. V'cheinu oimer sos onechi al imrosecho. Mitzvah Mila is associated to Amirais. The other mitzvahs were said Vayidabir, and regarding Mila it says Vayomer. And these Imrosecha, referring to Mila, is associated to Sosin, as the Pasuk says, Sos Onechi al Imrosecha. Continues the Gemara, V'yekar, when the Pasuk says that Klal Yisrael, Lehudim o'Yisoira v'simcha v'sosin v'yekar, Elu Tfilin, is referring to Tfilin. Yakor is a lashon of kovod, and we find tefillin associated to kovod. V'cheinu oimer v'roo chol amei haaretz kishem Hashem nikra alecha v'yoru mimecha. When the amei haaretz will see you, what will they see? Kishem Hashem nikra alecha. Then they will have a yiras hakovod from you. V'tanya b'leza gadol oimer elu tefillin sheberoish. When it says kishem Hashem nikra alecha, what's the shem Hashem nikra alecha? They are the tefillin sheberoish. Rashi explains that taka this nes happened at the Purim story when it says Kinofal Pachad Mordechai Aleim. Now the Gemara is continuing to the next Pasuk in Megillas Esther Perek Tes, Pasuk Zayin 2 to Yud. Ve'is Pasharam Doso Vegoimer Aseres Bene Homon Ben Amdoso Tsoirer HaYehudim Harogu. Omar Rav Ado Min Yofui. Rabbi Ado from the town of Yafa said as follows: Aseres Bene Homon, the names of the 10 sons of Homon that were hung, Ve'aseres, and the word Aseres, which it says immediately after them, Tsorich Lemimrinu Beneshima Achas, have to be said in one breath. My Tama, what's the reason for this? Explains the Gemara, Kulhu Behadi Adodi Nafku Nishmosayu. They all died on exactly the same moment. Omar Rabbi Yechanan, says Rabbi Yechanan, Vov de Vaizosa, the last of the 10 sons of Haman, Vaizosa, the Vov Tzorich Lemimtecha Bezkifa, has to be a long Vov, similar to a long piece of wood. Kamoi Radio, like the oars, the sticks that are used, the Livrois, when sailing through the river called Livrois, that they use these sticks to keep the boats away from the stones. My Tama, why does this Vov have to be long? In order to hint to us that Kulu Bechad Zkifa is the Kifu, that all the 10 sons were hung on a single long stick, which was the gallows, one above the other. Now the Gemara is going to discuss how the different shirois are written in the Tanakh. Omer Reb Chanina Bar Papa, Dorash Reb Shiloi Ish Kfar Tamarto. Kol HaShirois, the 8 shirois in Tanakh, the Shiras Hayom in Beshalach, Shiras Abair, Shiras Hazinu, the Malchei Knan Shenergu in Yeshua Perikud Beis, Shiras Dvoira, Shiras David in Shmuel Beis Perikhov Beis. There's the Lechol Zman Va'es in Keheles Perikimel, and there's the Aseres Bnei Haman in Esther Periktes. All of these, Kulon Nichtovis Oriach Al Gaba Leveino or Leveino Al Gaba Oriach, that the words that are written on each line are followed by empty space below it. An Oriach is a short stone, a Leveino is a long stone, and however long the words are, the gap, the space underneath it, where there was no words written, is even longer. Chutz mishirazu, besides the Aseres Bnei Haman, the Malchi Knan, and the Shira that was sung when the 31 Melochim of Knan were killed, in Yeshua Perikud Beis, She'oriach al gaba oriach, u'leveino al gaba leveino, that words were written on top of words, and gaps were on top of gaps. It was written in columns. My Tama, why are these two written in columns? She'loi tehet kumolem apoloson. Since these two Shirois are praising Hashem for the downfall of Roshoim, they're written in a way that reflects on a wall that is weaker than if it's Oreach al Gaba Leveino. When there's a small stone on top of a large stone, the wall is much stronger. But if it's one column of stones on top of each other, it's easier for it to collapse. And we don't want the Mapaloson Shel Roshoim to ever revive itself. We want the Roshoim to be gone and to stay down. So this is hinted to the type of wall that's easy to collapse and difficult to repair. Says the Pasuk in Esther Tes Yud Beis, Vayemer HaMelech LeEsther HaMalko, B'Shushan HaBira Horgu HaYehudim V'Abed Chamesh Mir'is Ish V'Goymer, U'ma She'ilosech V'inosin Lach. So Rashi explains that from the beginning of the Pasuk is Mashma, that Achashverosh was speaking to her a little bit out of anger. Only at the end, he was speaking nicely and he said to her, Uma she'ilosech v'inosinoch. Omer bavo, melamed, shebo malach ustori al piv. After Achashverosh started speaking in an angry tone, the malach smacked him on his mouth, and therefore he started speaking in a calmer fashion. It says in Pasuk Chofei, when Esther came lifnei HaMelech, Omar im haseifa yoshuv machshavta yoroa shechoshav al hayehudim al reishoi. The Gemara asks, it was Esther that came in, so it wasn't Omar, which is Loshen Zohar. It should be Omra, she said, not he said. So the Gemara says, Omar, Omra miboyle. It was Esther who asked that Haman's plans should be reversed. Answers the Gemara, Omar b'yechanon, ye Omar b'peh, mashekosuv b'seifa. So the Omar is not referring to Esther speaking, it was her request that Klal Yisrael should be commanded that they should Omar im ha-seifa, whatever's written in the seifa, referring to Megillas Esther, should actually be said and read every year. And the words, ubevoyo lifnei ha-melech, is telling us that even this part of the story should be said every Purim. Ubevoyo lifnei ha-melech, Omar im ha-seifa. When saying, when reading the Megillah every year, make sure to include the stage of Bevoyo lifnei ha-melech. Now, it says in Pasuk Lamed, Vayishlach Sforim el kol ha-Yehudim v'goymer Divrei Sholim v'emes. The Megillah is referred to Divrei Sholim v'emes. And the Gemara explains, Omer b'tanchim v'omri la Omer Reb Asi. There was a debate whether it was Reb Tanchim or Reb Asi who explained this. Melamei shetzricho sirtot ka'amito shel Torah. In the same way as a Sefer Torah, called Amito Shel Torah, must be written with Sirtut, the lines that determine that the Sefer is going to write in a straight line have to be etched into the parchment, so too Megillah needs to have Sirtut between the lines. Now in Pasuk Lamed Aleph it says, V'kashe kimu al nafsham v'al zarom divrei atzoimus v'za'akosom. And then in Pasuk Lamed Beis it says, U'mamar Esther kiem Divrei Purim O'Eile V'Nichtov Baseifer. Even though the Pasuk says that the Nes transpired after Hishtadlus, that Kimu Al Nafshom V'Al Zarom Divrei Atzoimis V'Zakosom, they all fasted and davened. Nonetheless, in the second Pasuk it says, U'mamar Esther Kiem Divrei Purim O'Eile, that it was the Hishtadlus of Esther with Achashverosh that saved Klal Yisrael. Asks the Gemara, Maimar Esther in, it was Esther's Hishtadlus that brought the Nes, Divrei Atzoimis Loi, but the fasting of Klal Yisrael did not contribute to the Nisim? Answers the Gemara, Omer B'Yechanon. B'Yechanon says you have to merge the two psukim. Divrei Atzoimis V'Zakosom U'mamar Mordechai. Through all of these, Kiem Divrei Apurim O'Eile. The Purim Nes transpired. At the end of the Megillah, Perek Yud Pasuk Gimel, it says, Ki Mordechai ha-Yehudi mishne la-melech ha-chashverish, v'godoy la-Yehudim, v'rotzui l'roiv echov. The Gemara's Madaik, that it seems that Mordechai HaTzadik only found favor in the eyes of most of his brothers. L'roiv echov, v'loy l'kol echov, but not to all his brothers. M'lameid shepirshu mimenu miktas Sanhedrin. After Mordechai started going in and out of the royal palace, and that caused him to lessen the amount of time that he could engage in Torah learning, and therefore some of the Sanhedrin distanced themselves from Mordechai somewhat. Now the Gemara is bringing a memra regarding the chashivos of Talmud Torah. Omar of Yosef says of Yosef, Godol Talmud Torah Yosef me'atzolas nefoshes. Learning Torah is even more important than saving lives. To Meikora, at the beginning, when the first group of Klal Yisrael came back from Golus to Eretz Yisrael, when Kirish first took the throne, Choshev Leila Mordechai Bosor Arbo. When the Pasuk lists the Choshev people, Mordechai was the fourth on the list. Ulebasoif, but the second Aliyah, in the time of Daryovish II, that was after Mordechai was forced to lessen the amount of time he could engage in Torah learning, and he had to engage in Hatzoras Nefoshes, Bosor Chamisha, his name is mentioned after five of the other Choshevim. Mikoroksiv, in Ezra Perek Beis it says, Ve'ele b'nei ha-medina ha-oilim mishvi ha-goyla v'goymer, asher bo'u im Zerubbabel, Yeshua, Nehemia, Sroya, Re'aliya, Mordechai, Bilshan. He was mentioned after four others. Ulebasayif, in the second Aliyah, Ksiv it says in the Pasuk in Nehemia Perek Zayin, Ha-bo'u im Zerubbabel, Yeshua, Nehemia, Azaria, Ra'amya, Nachmoni, Mordechai, Bilshan. He's mentioned after five others' names. And the reason that he was somewhat downgraded was because he was Oisek in Atzolos Nefoshes and had to reduce the amount of time he could engage in Torah learning. Now the Gemara brings another memra on the chashivas of Limud HaTorah. Omar Rav v'itemer Rav Shmuel bar Marta, Godol Talmud Torah yoisem ebinyin Beis Hamikdash. It's greater to learn Torah than to build the Beis Hamikdash. Shekol zman sheboruch bein Neiria Kayom, when the Rebbe of Ezra, called Baruch ben Uriah, was still alive, Lo hini Nichoy Ezra Ve'olo. Ezra did not leave his Rebbe in Bovel and come up to Eretz Yisrael and build the Beis HaMikdash, because he was still learning Torah from his Rebbe. He didn't come up in the Aliyah Rishayna B'Yimei Koresh, he only came up in the Aliyah Shnia in the Tkufa of Dariyavesh HaSheini.